I found this transparent breaker with GFCI on AliExpress and decided to show you how it works. I will do basic explanation. If you want to find more advanced information, you can check comments. Maybe someone smart will write more advanced information, but I will show you basics of how it works. This device is made from two parts. On the left side we have a breaker, and on the right side we have GFCI. You can see that it is split into two parts, but those parts are connected. I will show you how later. Let's start from explaining the breaker. We have input on the top, and in this example at the bottom we have output, but this output goes back to the input of the GFCI. And what happens between the input and the output? Now, when the breaker is disabled, we have a gap right here. And if I enable it, it connects right here, as you can see. And if I move it halfway, it's already connected, so the power is flowing through this breaker. But if I let it go, it disables instantly. And if I go further, now it is locked in the turn-on position. And you can see the power is flowing from the input through this arm, this cable right here, this coil, this cable right here, and here to the exit. And how it can detect the current that it is flowing through it, that it's too big. It has two ways. On the bottom, here is a metal part made from two different metals. And if the current is too big, it is heating up. And when it is heating up, it is bending, and when it bends enough, it triggers the breaker. And on the bottom you can see there is a screw that in the factory they calibrated the device to trigger at the correct current. You cannot adjust this screw, it is only adjusted in the factory. So this is one way. This is used if, for example, this breaker is for 6 amps, and you would put 8 amps through it, it would heat up and disable the breaker. But second thing is this coil right here. This is for detecting short circuit. If there is a short, the current that will flow will be really high. This pin right here will go down and it will disable the breaker. Also right here we have arc chamber. Its purpose is to quicker dispose the arc that can happen when you break the connection right here when the power is flowing. It should quicker dispose the arcs. So this is the breaker part. Simple mechanism but working really well. And now let's see the GFCI part. Right here from the breaker output we have a cable that goes to the GFCI, and I could right here disconnect this cable and use this breaker just as a breaker without the GFCI. It would have input and output, but this is a combination with breaker with GFCI. So in this example, this output goes to the GFCI, and GFCI also needs a second cable, the neutral cable. And inside you can see the thick red and blue cables. They go twice through this coil. This coil detects if the current going through the blue and red cable, so live and neutral cables, is the same. If the current is not matching, there is difference between current on these two cables, and breakers have the allowed current, for example, 30 milliamps. If the current is above, it means that the current is leaking somewhere, for example, through someone's body. So if it detects that the current doesn't match on those two cables, it will trigger. And how it will trigger? On the back we have PCB, and here we have electromagnet. So when the current doesn't match on those two cables, it activates this electromagnet. And this electromagnet does two things. It pops the breaker, but also this locks the breaker, so you cannot turn it on without resetting the GFCI. And also on the top we have a button that can test if the GFCI is working. You should test it every few months in your home if it is working. If it doesn't pop the breaker, it needs replacing because it is not working. And I will show you examples how it works in practice. we turn on the breaker, connection is made, and I will use this tester to trigger the breaker. And you can see it shut down, and now the GFC popped out. And now when I try to enable the breaker, I cannot enable it. As you can see, the connection is not making right here. I have to press this button, but make a close look. You can see this part. It's moving forward and blocking the connection. But when I press this button and now move it, now it is locked and makes the connection. When this is not resetted, I cannot turn on the breaker. Let's see the other angle. Here we can see from the bottom. Now it triggers and reset it. Also from this side. This is how it looks like. So I hope you learned something new. If you have additional information that you would like to share, write them in the comments. And that's all for today. Like, subscribe, and be nice.